In this video, I will introduce the process of creating idle animation, the basic motion of action games. In general, idle motion means standing posture. I will make the animation that the character does preparatory exercise composed of three movements. First, add an animation clip and set the name as idle. Select the mesh group, and register the transform by animation modifier as a timeline. Press the All Bones to Layers button to register all the bones as timeline layers. Modify the animation's end frame to change the length of the animation. Press the Start Edit button to turn on edit mode. Press S key to turn off selection lock. Make the basic posture while checking that the rigging created from the previous video is correct. Rotate the scarf on the back of your neck down and correct the posture of legs and arms. Idle motion has a default posture basically, and it is good to make it a loop animation with slightly deformed postures in middle frames. You can copy the posture at once by holding down the Control key and dragging the common keyframe. Edit the posture from the default posture. Repeat this process to add slightly deformed postures. To give fun to ordinary animations, let's add to the first part the gesture of kicking the left foot to the ground. Add some keyframes for the bones on both legs and move the foot bone up and down. It is easy to create because IK is set. Adjust the spacing of keyframes. Now the character is kicking the ground with the left foot. However, it is a little awkward because it only moves legs. Make the other parts move slightly. You do not need to add keyframes in perfect synchronization with the movement of the leg. Modify the position of some keyframes because they are awkward if the positions of the added keyframes are all the same. The second action is that the character crosses the legs back and forth. Press the Add Keyframes to All Layers button to add keyframes. It is recommended that you move the pelvis bone first when you create a motion in which the entire body moves. Make the posture so that the right leg comes forward and the left leg goes back. Make arms move in the opposite direction to legs. It now makes the legs and arms crossed. The left leg comes forward, and the right leg goes backward. Now the character is acting like she is practicing running. The third action is to jump in place. The process of jumping consists of three stages: preparation, jump, and landing. First, create a posture in which the character bends and prepares for jumping. Then, create a posture in which the character expands and jumps. Before making a landing posture, I tried to make the jump repeat once more. Finally, I copied the posture of the preparation stage and used it as a landing step. If the landing posture is the same as the preparation step, it is awkward. Modify the landing step. Now let's erase the last keyframes and play. An idle animation consisting of three actions has been created. Now let's make this animation better. Although described in previous tutorials, if all the keyframes of different parts of the body are all in the same position, it becomes a fairly artificial animation. So you need to distribute the keyframes according to the characteristics of the action. Finally, let's create an animation of the scarf. The scarf has physical movement due to inertia. Repeatedly flapping up and down will be the most natural and effective animation. When the body does not move too much, let's make it flap up and down independently. Otherwise, when the body moves more like a jump, it is better to follow the movement of the body in the degree of flutter or time. Let's play the animation. It seems a little artificial, but it looks okay at this stage. Apply this process to the other scarf. Now it is time to distribute the position of the keyframes of the scarf. When creating an inertial animation, it is best to place the keyframes with a slight time difference from the inside to the outside and vice versa. In this case, the scarf is moved by the body, so the more the bone is located on the outside, the more the keyframe should be located behind. When you play an animation, it shows a much better movement. Now let's select the root unit and test it. Idle motion repeats. Three postures have been completed. In the next video, we will create a running and a jump motion.